I decided to give number one its own part because I have quite a bit to talk about with this one. No, I knew from the start that Gravity Falls episode would be my number one. How could it not be? This show is filled with so much mystery, macabre, and just general eeriness that it would be a crime not to put an episode of the show at number one. And there are plenty of episodes to choose from. There's the Giffany episode, there's Weird Mageddon parts 1 and 3. And although my rules negate it as a possibility, there was also the Summerween episode. But in the end, the most disturbing episode of this show, and the most disturbing episode of any cartoon, in my opinion, is Northwest Mansion Mystery. Starters, this episode is chock full of disturbing imagery. It uses the medium of animation to create truly disturbing visuals and is incredibly creative all the way through. It's the stuff of nightmares, and it really consolidates the tone. And the urgency and suspense just skyrocketed. Absolutely amped up to 11. I mean, with the floating objects, the decapitated heads of animals dripping with blood and chanting ancient sins, it really works to the episode's advantage. It makes it all the more disturbing with all the imagery. But it's not just the imagery. There's a lot of disturbing concepts and implications in this episode as well. Of course, there's the paralysis thing, which, again, loss of control. It personally terrifies me, the thought of being paralyzed. And just something about the way it's done in this episode makes it more disturbing. I don't know what it is.
The mudslides began. While they partied and laughed, I was swept away by the storms.
Not to mention manslaughter and brutal death scene. But speaking of that death scene, the villain of this episode, well, he's technically not the villain of the episode. He's big and menacing and has blue fire for hair. Now they're just ripping off themselves. And his sheer power is enough to make him terrifying. But the disturbingness isn't the only thing to like about this episode. Not only do they give Pacificum a lot of likability and depth, which he didn't have before in this episode. In fact, for once, I didn't want her off the screen. But her and Dipper share a really likable chemistry and even kind of a enjoyably quirky romance. Although understandably doesn't go anywhere past friendship. Also, she does kind of backtrack a bit in Weird Mageddon, but it's understandable. And the ending of the episode is delightfully uplifting. It again puts Pacifica in a good light instead of just as the one-dimensional character that she normally is.
Pacifica, you are not like the other Northwests. I feel lumber justice.
There's a disturbing set of scenes in which Pacifica argues with her parents, and her father rings a bell. This makes her immediately silence. It's really uncomfortable.
Overall, a good, if not disturbing, episode with lots of suspense. And that was my number one and my list. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you had a good Halloween. But now that Halloween is over, it's time for me to start celebrating Christmas. Scott? What? I've been picking up some strange readings from the TARDIS. I was wondering if any odd things have been happening recently. Yeah, there was this weird random supercomputer that appeared out of nowhere. Did you have anything to do with that? Computer? Are you sure a supercomputer has nothing to do with you? No, that doesn't ring a bell. Okay, but you know you gotta get out of my video soon.
You say something.
Don't change the subject.
Huh? Trap and wait. When he comes a snipping, we will snap the trap and close the gate.
Wait, I've got